You're a sick hombre. Take a seat.
Bloody hell, boys. How good?
Bit of Daft Punk.
Hey? Bit of Daft Punk. I lost myself to dance there and possibly lost something else as well, but bloody hell, it's great to be alive, boys, and we're so blessed to have to celebrate this amazing milestone together as a tripod.
What milestone?
Oh, come on. It's our 12th show, 12th episode, and you know, and you got to celebrate every small victory, as Nick Farr-Jones said in 91, so that's a very famous quote. But yeah, it's great to be alive, boys, and we've got a fantastic show. Oh yeah, also, for all the people that haven't signed up to the TAB, make sure you head to our site, tab.co.nz, use BALLS20 as the promo code, deposit 20, and we'll give you 20 bucks back. And we've also got a great rugby prize to give away, believe it or not.
It's a flat rugby ball.
All our punters at home, if you guess the right score this weekend between the ABs and South Africa, you could win this deflated Gilbert.
Why is it special?
Well, this is donated by Bodie Barrett and voluntary. And yeah, down in down the glass box. He actually kicked it into the crowd after he missed one of his conversions, and I obviously naturally stole it. So it's got some good signatures on here. This one over here, it says Grant. I'm guessing that's you, big fella, and also Staffy, and Tubby Tony. So it's actually signed by all us three, which is a great gift. So yes, score prediction down in the comments, and we'll send this out to you. Nisbo, you look a bit different today, mate. Well, you have a haircut.
Why, when I see you, do I think of deflated, talking of a deflated ball? Why do you come to mind?
Mate, obviously, you're getting closer to your 300th calling of an AB game. How exciting is that? Absolute stalwart, mate.
Yeah, it's a lot of rugby, isn't it, really? And people say to me, what's the best game you ever saw? And I've got about five of them. There's no one game that really stands out, but I hope Albany on Saturday night does. So I've got a feeling this might be a pretty good game.
Fellas, the game that was against Argentina, obviously the Argies were all over us like a dirty rash, and but when we found it, open space, geez, real good, dynamic. Vi Fifita, how good was he, Steph?
Oh, look, big raps on him ever since I first saw him, and he's just got so much speed. He's got a lot more size now. I love the way he wears tape as well around his knees and around his thighs. He just looks like a wounded gazelle that's ignoring the pain.
Great simile. Anyway, Steph, why don't you play some footage, and Grant, I'll give you my best interpretation on how to commentate a game, mate, and you can give me some tips.
Here we go. Ant, you ready?
I'm ready.
Go.
The Argies all over the ball like eczema. They look to clear it, but it's been charged down by Dane Coles and his massive shaved head, regathered by TJ Perenara, who throws a huge willy-nilly no-looker to the big bunch of banana-like hands of Vi Fifita. And here he goes, around one, now two. Oh, he's making them look like a pack of malnourished armadillos searching frantically for their mother's teat for milk. Fifita, you absolute gorgeous long-legged converted to a blindside scrummaging sensei of a flanker. That is the tastiest, meatiest pie you'll ever score, you young son of a gun. The crowd erupts in laughter.
Jeez.
Laughter.
Well, there's so much emotion. You don't know what to do. I think it's more laughing at how many people he beat as a lock that's converted to a blindside flanker. Grant.
Nisbo, be kind.
Sure.
My immediate thought is, hang on to your day job. And it wasn't a TV commentary, was it? Surely not. It was a radio commentary. But, interesting enough. Hey, keep in touch. We'll see what we can do.
Grant, you have to sit next to Justin Marshall in the box, who's probably got the most painful commentary. Me and him could make a great duo.
Oh, I love Marshy.
Yeah.
Me oh my.
Me oh my.
Yes, boy.
Yes.
Boy. Yes, boy. Oh, yeah. Yes, boy. Can I just interrupt here and say that it's a very open plan box at Albany. Mm. And so you could probably bring 20 of your mates, and I wouldn't even know they were there.
Oh, that's a dangerous invite.
I didn't say that.
Okay, Steph, let's look ahead to, obviously, the match, the South Africans versus the ABs. The South Africans do have the advantage, playing at QBE Stadium in front of the home fans. Let's look at the front row. We've got Kane Hames,
not that experienced.
Now, Lala's
also starting as well. These South Africans are big brutes, mate.
I just have to interrupt you about Kane Holmes.
Yes.
He actually prefers to be called by his birth name, which is Kanye James. Not many people...
Is he Mexican?
He's Kanye. Yeah, but he felt a bit bad by it, so he's changed his name to Kane, but he actually is Kanye James.
I dare you to drop that in the commentary in the weekend, mate.
I don't know the bloke.
You just don't have the balls to do it, mate. That's for you know.
No,
I
you're
would.
Quite right.
Yeah, I would. You know, I'm all about pushing the boundaries and getting the ratings up. This is why we're so successful. They're a tough bunch, Nisbo. You know, the All Blacks, if they're going backwards in the scrums and we're not taking our high balls with our back three, we could be in a bit of a pickle, won't we?
Yeah, look, we haven't been going backwards in scrums for a long time. We won't be going backwards in scrums here either. Put the rent on it.
Well, the All Blacks have won 9 of their last 10 against the Box, so it's safe to say that history doesn't lie, that we're probably in the driver's seat. No surprises there, Steph. Where is your head this weekend, mate?
Oh, look, I just think we've seen some really competitive games from Argentina and Australia, and all the talk this week's been about that rush defence and all that sort of thing, and I think South Africa, we mentioned at the start of the Rugby Championship in EP 4 or 5 that they're much better coached, much better led. So I'm not expecting a blowout. I'm expecting it much tighter and a real physical battle. Can't wait. I'm a big fan of Eben Etzebeth's biceps.
Are you coming out the closet live on this show, Steph?
No. I'm going to go All Blacks 12 and under. I think the $3.25. Rain around all the time in Auckland. Rain's pretty much every day in Auckland. The pitch will be a little bit dusty.
This bit.
I'm going to go Dane Coles to get a try. He's overdue. He's back. He's had 3 or 4 games. Time for a try. Dane Coles.
Halftime draw, $13.
Halftime draw. I'm looking at it right here. $13.
Yeah.
A draw at halftime.
Yeah. Well, it also depends who's taking the kicks. And
Well, Bodie will be taking the kicks.
Yeah. So hopefully the boy can deliver the goods. And but that's exciting. Yeah, well, lads, I'll see you not next week, but the week after for Head, Heart and Balls. And fantastic show, fellas. Great to have you back on board.
Hot hands.